Welcome to class 9th biology children. Today we are discussing about crop protection methods. Some methods are there to get more yield. So first method is weeds. So if you manage weeds in a proper way, weeds means kalupu mokkalu, if you manage weeds in a proper way in your crop, you will get more yield. Okay, so if you observe your crop, generally it contains some unwanted plants in it. These unwanted plants are called weeds. Okay, if you remove the weeds, then you will get more yield. Okay, for example, see some questions are there in this topic. First one, how would you weeds affect the supply of nutrients to the crop? So if so many weeds are there in our crop, then what will happen? The weeds, they will take more amount of water and also nutrients from the soil. As a result of this, what will happen? Cropping plants doesn't get proper nutrients and sufficient quantity of water, so yield will be gradually decreases. Second question, how would they affect the sunlight available to the crop? If you observe the cropping plants, if they contains any weeds in it, these weeds, they will cover the total cropping plants. As a result of this, cropping plants doesn't get sunlight in a proper way. Next, what effect will there be on the water availability for the crop? So if weeds are there in our crops, then what will happen? Weeding plants, they require more amount of water, so they will draw more water. As a result of this, cropping plants will get only few quantity of water, so the yield will be gradually decreases. Will these factors affect the crop production? Yes, these are all the factors, they will affect the crop production. Let us come to observe another topic, insects and plant diseases. So some insects, they will cause destruction on our crops. Next, some diseases also causes destruction. Because of the insects population, because of the diseases, our crop yield will gradually decreases. Let us observe some important points in the topic. Some insects eat the stem of plants. Some insects, they will eat the stem of the plants. Some nibbles at the leaves while other destroys the roots. So if you observe the insects, they will mainly attack three parts. Some insects, they will attack plants, stems of the plants. Some insects, they will attack leaves. Some insects, they will attack roots of the plant. But there are also insects that are useful for plants. So what we are discussing, about the insects which attacks stems of the plants, which attacks leaves of the plant, and which attacks roots of the plants, they will always reduces crop production. But some friendly insects are there. These are very useful for the plants. For example, many insects helps in the pollination of plants. If you observe insects in our surroundings, many insects, they will helpful in the pollination of plants. All of you observe these figures. So in these figures we can see honeybees fluttering on flower, butterfly fluttering on flower. Next, another insect is also there. So these all, they are helpful in the pollination of flowers. There are several microorganisms that destroys plants. We cannot see them, but we can see the destructions they causes in plants. All of you observe these figures. So in these figures we can see the destruction on plants. This is a lady's finger plant. Next, lady's finger plant. Next, this is chili's plant. Next, this is a brinjal plant leaf. Okay, so in these three crops we can see destructions caused by the microorganisms, but we cannot see the microorganisms. Okay, why? For the reason, microorganisms are very smaller. Next, these include shriveling and discoloration of leaves. What they included? They include a shriveling of leaf. Shriveling means leaves anevi chuttuku povadam, ikkada observe cheyochu. Next, discoloration of leaves. Discoloration means, I think you know, ओके सो कलर अने पाड़ी नैक्स्ट रस्टिंग ऑफ द स्टेम रस्टिंग मीन तुप पटन स्टेम मीद तुप मरकला कम नैक्स्ट रस्टिंग ऑफ द स्टेम अंड आलो लीव्स फंगल ग्रोथ एट्सेट्रा ओके सो दीज ऑल आर द डिस्ट्रक्शंस कॉज्ड बाय द इंसेक्ट्स ओके द डिजीज़ कॉज्ड बाय द इंसेक्ट्स एंड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म्स अफेक्ट द क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन सो इफ एनी इंसेक्ट आर एनी माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट अटैक्स द क्रॉपिंग प्लांट्स देन व्हाट विल हैपन क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन विल बी ग्रेडुअली इंक्रीजेस नाउडेज़ फार्मर्स आर यूजिंग इंसेक्टिसाइड्स fungicides and other chemicals however there are other ways are also there to solve the problem for example weeding could rid a field of weeds okay see nowadays farmers are using insecticides insecticides means the chemicals which are useful to kill the insects next fungicides fungicides means the chemicals which are useful to kills the fungal activity on the cropping plants called fungicides next these fungicides and insecticides we are using now however there are other ways are also there to solve the problem so some other ways are also there to solve these problems for example weeding weeding means kalupu teeyadam so if you remove the weeds from your cropping plants then what will happen they are useful to give more yield next another method is also there insects can be captured and removed from the fields so if you find any harmful insects you should capture them and you should remove from the fields insecticides are actually chemicals they are used to kill the insects already we discussed insecticides insecticides means the chemicals which are useful to kill the insects are called insecticides next when we use the insects to kill pests or weedicides herbicides to destroy weeds a large percentage of these chemicals remains in the soil so if you use any chemicals to remove the weeds then what will happen these chemicals simply enters into the soil so from the soil these chemicals find their way into the water resources so from that soil what will happen these chemicals simply spreads into water resources means into water bodies like into rivers oceans seas whatever may be it is these chemicals will enters into those water bodies next people who spray these chemicals in the fields are exposed to them and some of the chemicals enters into their body also so during the spraying of these chemicals some chemicals will enters into their body also so as a result of this what will happen they will injure let us observe in our state Prakasam and Guntur districts are the places where the pesticides and insecticides are used in larger quantities so in our state mainly two districts are there what they are Prakasam and Guntur districts both the districts are using insecticides and pesticides in larger quantities when compared to other districts here in these figures we can see some friendly insects honey bees butterfly and some other insects we can see these all are useful for the pollination purpose in the plants instead of using chemicals like insecticides fungicides some useful methods are there now we are going to discuss those useful methods there are many insects that eats other harmful insects they are called predatory insects some predatory insects are there these predatory insects always kills harmful insects present on our crop we can make use these insects there are also birds that eat insects we can use these birds to get rid of insects so if you want to remove insects from your crop you need to increase the bird population also whenever the birds population increases then what will happen they will eat harmful insects present on your crop okay similarly people say we can capture the harmful insects and kill them the problem is that this method is both slow and time consuming process so if you find any insects on your crop simply you need to capture them so how many insects, you can capture them within one day or within 2 days. Try to count, so many insects will be there. So you cannot capture all the insects within the proper time. So this method is very slow and also time consuming process. Let us discuss natural pest controlling methods. Some natural pest controlling methods are also there. Now we are going to discuss. There are so many natural pest controlling techniques are there. Some insects controls the harmful insects and they are called friendly insects. Already we discussed about predatory insects. These are also called friendly insects. These insects are always kills harmful insects. That is why these are called friendly insects or predatory insects. Let us observe some friendly insects names. Spiders, dragonfly, tunigal, merits, ladybird, beetles, etc. These all are the friendly insects. Are the insects that eats larvae of jar seeds, thrips and stem borers, some fungi like harmful insects. So if you increase the spiders, dragonfly, merids, ladybirds like some friendly insects, they will eat fungal, bacterial and viral organisms. All of you observe in these figures, we can see friendly insects which kills harmful insects. Here in the first figure, this is a harmful insect and this is friendly insect. Next, this one is a friendly insect. Next, this is harmful insect. Here also in third figure, this is friendly insect and this is harmful insect. This is grasshopper. This is friendly insect. Next, this is harmful insect. So if you increase the friendly insects on your crops, then what will happen? They will eat harmful insects present on your crops. As a result of this, crop yield will be gradually increases. Let us see some important points in this chapter. Some mixed cropping method is also controls some pests and diseases. So if you follow the mixed crop method, it also useful to protect your crop from pests and also from diseases. After paddy cultivating, black gram, groundnut, etc. prevents tongue grow viral disease on paddy. So after cultivation of paddy, if you cultivate black gram or groundnut, then what will happen? Again, if you cultivate paddy, then it can be recovered from, it can be protect itself from tongue grow viral disease. Next, after cotton cultivating, mange and chinchilli prevent gram caterpillar. After cotton cultivation, if you cultivate mange, mange means chonnalu, chinchilli, chinchilli means nuvulu. Okay, so after cotton cultivation, if you cultivate mange or chinchilli, it is useful to protect your cotton crop from a gram caterpillar. Caterpillar nunchi save chestundi. Next, after red gram cultivating, mange and corn prevents spotted bollworm and dry disease. So after red gram cultivation, if you cultivate mange and corn, corn means mokkajonna, in the same land, then what will happen? Again, if you cultivate a red gram, then it can be protected from spotted bollworm and also dried disease. So these all are called as akarshaka pantalu. Which pantalu? These all are called akarshaka pantalu. Let us see. Improvement in food production and sustaining soil health as well as environmental protection are the challenges of agricultural practices. Farmers should be aware of quality innovative practices in agriculture. So what we have to do? We have to follow some innovative practices in the agriculture and we need to follow the rules given by sustainable development. We need to follow sustainable development rules also. Then only what will happen? We can save the soil and we can get a more yield. Okay children, our chapter 8 is completed. In our next class, we are going to discuss chapter 9. Thank you, children.